Welcome back to Hellblade, Senua's Sacrifice. We should have all the fragments, and now I should be able to pull the sword out of the tree.
Dillian gave her the strength to pass the warrior trials, and she saw a way out. To leave her past behind, and become a warrior in Dillian's clan.
The sword is tainted by the gods of darkness. Leave it.
No. He left it here. He wants me to take it.
You will pay a price for this.
But years later, with Zinbal's parting words still haunting her, the darkness came back with a vengeance. Plague.
Dillian?
Everyone suffered.
My father was not supposed to die like this.
Dillian?
Do you see it clearly now, Senua? The suffering you've caused.
This is your fault. You brought this plague to us! You have blood on your hands!
They're coming for you now.
They're coming.
They're coming to get you.
Hold your heavy strike. Hold it. Hold the heavy strike. Hold it. Hold it. Hold your hands. Unleash the sword.
Okay, so I gotta focus to be able to hit him, I think.
Surprise him! Focus! Focus!
Over the ones I loved. The ship broke up under them. The ship that had sailed from the land of shining fields. Their memorial stone a secret. Come not here in the sun. Come not with a sword. Come not crying over a naked corpse. Come not with disturbed mind.
Jesus Christ.
Do you hear the suffering, Senua? Does your precious gift of sight let you see the souls that rot here in this sea of corpses?
Behind you!
Do you feel the blood running cold on your skin? Do you hear their endless cries? Do you smell their putrid wounds? They were once brothers, sisters, and loved ones. And look at what you have done to them. All because you were a coward, because you ran from your curse instead of facing it. When you turned your back on your father, Zinbal, you turned your back on the gods and let the darkness wreak havoc on your people. Why must they pay for your heresy?
Thank you.
voice of your mother, Galena. She calls for you, Senua. Go to her. Answer her pitiful call.
I need you. Help me.
Doubted the gods and let the darkness infest her. But she didn't run. She escaped the only way she knew how. She gave her life to the gods.
If only you had done the same, the world would have been spared this horror.
It's not too late. She's calling for you. Why don't you join her?
Surprisingly hard to get away from enemies. You can sprint towards them, but I don't think you can sprint away from them. Got my focus ready to use, thankfully. Got the hard one down.
Find us your position. Don't let them surround you.
Get out! She will die.
hello.
Fight it anymore. Not on my own. Where are you, Mother? I want to be with you.
That night, she gave up on her world to follow in the footsteps of her mother. To go to a place where the darkness couldn't reach her.
Senua, look at me.
Do you hear them? They're calling for me.
We've lost so many. And I've lost my father. I can't lose you.
You said it. I have blood on my hands.
I didn't say that. You've done nothing wrong.
Simba was right. Everyone will suffer.
Zimbal is a fake. He is a hateful, bitter liar. He's poison. And his words still haunt you. Who do you trust? Him? Or me? Do you still believe in me, Senua? In us? Come back to me. Please. Don't let this darkness come between us.
Into the mountain.
Can you see it?
Shall we tell her where to go?
It's not far. Go on.
Look up.
Just up there. Listen to us.
Is it?
Shall we tell her to go?
Shall we?
Does she know which way to look?
Does she know her way to the mountain?
She's a good girl, isn't she? Look.
Voices are so encouraging right now.
Tell you of a great hero named Sigurd, son of Sigmund, no less. Born after his father's death, Sigurd is cared for by the dwarf Reyn. But Reyn does not love the boy. Instead, he plans to use him for his own ends. You see, Reyn's father possessed a great treasure given to him by the gods. But Reyn's brother, Fafnir, killed his father and took the gold all for himself. Fafnir hid the treasure out on a heath and could not leave it. And from the evil in his heart, he turned into a dark creature. A dragon.
Can you feel it?
Something behind the door.
What is it?
She can feel it.
No.
Don't open the door.
No, go in. Don't open the
door. What's it?
Guards Helheim. Garm is its name, and it knows you are here, Senua. It can smell your stink. What are you afraid of, Senua? How will you save Dillion if you are too much of a coward to step into the shadows?
They can't stop me.
Then do it. The beast is stalking you from the shadows. Your sword is useless here.
Oh, Christ. This game's surprisingly more horror than I thought it would be. It's got quite a few horror elements. Two ways to go. There's something over that way. I don't know what it is. Maybe a window or something. I don't see anything over that way, so let's go this way.
To do. Your father wants them to go away, and he only hurts me to silence them.
But he's gone now.
But they always come back. He says I will die if I go with them. They say that I'm already dead.
No,
and that they want me with them.
Stop!
That's why they crawl through the walls.
Don't listen.
Do you
to them.
See them? Do you see their faces?
She can't remember when it started. When her mother lost her smile. Her eyes gazing past her towards a world she could not see. This is what happens if you reach for the underworld, he said. It was a lot to take in for a child. And the first time she felt the cold chill. I don't talk much about her father, Zenbel. I suppose I just didn't want to risk upsetting her. But it doesn't matter now, does it?
A torch will go out, but I think there's light past there. I should be able to light these too. I'm gonna light every single one of these.
Rand the dwarf's sole desire is to possess this dragon's accursed treasure, and he uses Sigurd to reclaim it. He tells Sigurd the story of Fafnir's gold, and the good-hearted hero promises to slay the dragon if Rhaen would forge a strong sword for him. Sigurd remembers that his father once possessed a sword given to him by Odin. Odin broke the sword to bring about Sigmund's death, but Sigurd's mother still has the pieces. And so Rhaen reforges the famous sword. Sigurd uses the sword first to avenge his father, and then he and Rhaen go in search of Fafnir.
Okay, got one. Two more to go? Yeah, two more. So we're back here. It looked kind of like there was a pathway over here, maybe? Can we go up this? Oh.
The dragon Fafnir is so large and deadly that it would be impossible to kill him face to face. But each day, Fafnir crawls across the heath to find water. So Sigurd digs a pit in the dragon's path and lies in wait in it. When Fafnir slithers overhead, Sigurd sinks his sword into the dragon up to the hilt. Sigurd leaps from the pit, and Fafnir sees his killer. He warns Sigurd that the treasure will lead to his death, as it led to the death of Fafnir. Sigurd replies that death comes to all men, and every man would want to be wealthy until that day. And he takes the treasure.
Oh, good. I can light these too. Whoa! Wasn't expecting that.
Yeah. behind you! Hope! Stop! She will die. Stop!
Oof! Didn't even see them. Hard to see anything. I think the blood is the symbol. Probably need to look at it from up there. I just want to light as many lights as possible.
See the monster in her.